Welcome to a linear equation application. You started this year with $162 saved, and you continue to save $45 per month. Part A, write an equation to model the situation. Use M for the number of months and S for the amount saved. So using these variables, S, the amount saved, would be equal to the starting amount saved of $162. And then because you're saving $45 per month, we would have to add, or plus, 45 times m, or 45m. Notice each time m increases by 1, you'd add another $45 to the saved amount. Now because we're also studying linear equations in slope-intercept form, if we wanted to, we could also change the order of these two terms and write s equals 45m plus 162. Both of these equations are correct and equivalent, they're just in a slightly different form. There's one more thing to mention here. Notice the rate of change, or the slope of the line if we were to graph this, would be positive 45. The reason it's positive is because we're saving $45 each month, or we can say that S increases $45 each month. Part B, how much money will you have saved after 9 months? So we can use our equation here and substitute 9 for m to determine the amount saved after 9 months. We would have S equals 162 plus 45 times 9. So we'd have 162 plus 45 times 9 equals 405. And 162 plus 405 is equal to 567. Which means after 9 months, you've saved $567. Now for part C, how many months will it take to save for a new computer that costs $625? So to answer part C, we'll now substitute 625 for S and then solve for M. So we want to solve the equation 625 equals 162 plus 45m. So for the first step, we want to isolate the variable term, so we'll subtract 162 on both sides of the equation. This difference here is 463. This would be 0, so we have 463 equals 45m. The last step to solve for m, we would divide both sides by 45. Which means m is equal to 463 divided by 45. Let's go ahead and find this quotient on the calculator. 463 divided by 45. Notice how this quotient is approximately 10.29. But because we're saving money per month, notice after 10 months we would not have enough money for the computer. So we'd have to wait until the next month, or the 11th month. We'd actually have to round this up to the next whole number, or 11. So it will take 11 months to save enough to purchase the computer. After 11 months, we'd actually have more than enough money to purchase the computer. But it would take 11 months to have at least $625. Just to illustrate this, notice if we saved for 10 months, we'd have 162 plus 45 times 10. Notice that's not enough to purchase the computer. So if we save for one more month, or 11 months, we'd have 162 plus 45 times 11. Notice after 11 months, we do have enough money to purchase the computer that costs $625. I hope you found this explanation helpful.